Tropical Cyclone Fina, a Category 1 system, has now developed, located to the north of the Northern Territory. Impacts are likely for parts of the top end by Friday. Now, through the early hours of this morning, we did see the tropical low pressure system known as 02U gradually moving eastwards to the north of the Northern Territory. Through that time, we saw a rapid intensification, more quick than we were initially expecting. And the system reached tropical cyclone intensity around 4 o'clock this morning, Central Standard Time. Now, the system does look fairly close to the Northern Territory coast, but at this point in time, it's actually still located around 370 kilometres to the north-northeast of Darwin. We are seeing some showers, rain areas and thunderstorms impacting parts of the top end, but most of the impacts associated with this developing tropical cyclone are held closer to the system, out over the ocean to the north. But how will this system continue to develop today and over the next few days? Through the rest of today, we're likely to see tropical cyclone Fina gradually moving towards the east-northeast, likely reaching Category 2 intensity by Wednesday night, so by tonight. As we go into tomorrow, the system is likely to make a U-turn, hooking back around to the south and then gradually moving southwest towards the Northern Territory northern coastline. Now, it's around this time, late Thursday into Friday, that we might start to see more direct impacts developing for parts of the Northern Territory coastline and the Tiwi Islands. We can see this a little bit more clearly in our latest tropical cyclone track map and the tropical cyclone watch that is now current. Taking a look at those now, we'll focus on the track map first of all. This blue number here indicates the latest analysis for where tropical cyclone Fina is located. This is at a Category 1 system, but as you can see, by this evening, we are expecting the system to strengthen to Category 2 intensity. As I said, we're then expecting the system to move back around to the south, then southwest over the next few days, gradually coming closer to the Northern Territory coast once again, and possibly crossing this far northern part of the Northern Territory across the Coburg Marine Park by Saturday morning as a Category 2 system. Now, there are still a number of directions this system might develop, a number of directions it might move, including further to the east or further to the west, staying out over the water. However, this track map represents our best estimate of how this system will move over the coming days. Now, we do have a tropical cyclone watch also current. It's shown by these orange areas on this map. So the tropical cyclone watch currently extends from Milangimbi in the east all the way across that northernmost part of the Northern Territory and across the Tiwi Islands out to Cape Fourcroy in the west of Bathurst Island there. In this tropical cyclone watch area, we're likely to see gale force winds developing within the next 48 hours. For some areas, that might be as early as Thursday, but for others, we might not see that gale force wind developing until Friday morning. In fact, we may even see some locally destructive wind gusts up to 135 kilometres an hour developing for parts of the Northern Territory coastline between Cape Don and Warrawee through late Thursday into early Friday. So really, it's that end of the week period when we're likely to see the more direct impacts from tropical cyclone Fina developing. How will things play out after this time? Returning to our map here, we can see tropical cyclone Fina is most likely to then continue moving southwest through the Van Diemen Gulf, scraping that far western part of the top end as we go through the weekend. Again, there are still a few different scenarios as to exactly how this system might move, but we are likely to see the system passing close by Darwin or possibly making a coastal crossing somewhere in the vicinity over the weekend. This means that for Darwin, the worst of the impacts are likely to come this weekend. That includes the strong gale force, damaging, possibly destructive winds, an elevated sea state and storm surge, and of course the increased rainfall that we're expecting. Taking a look at our rainfall totals all the way out to the end of Sunday night, we can see this pattern here. The highest rainfall totals along that northwestern corner of the top end and across the Tiwi Islands, but the highest rainfall accumulations are expected where that system passes closest by. So that may include areas around Darwin. This is certainly the time to be prepared and be aware of what's to come. You can always find the latest forecasts and warnings via the Bureau's website, the Bomb Weather app, and via our social media. Stay safe and we'll catch you next time.